Good morning. You have reached the broadcast of the Mount Pleasant Baptist Church located in Herndon, Virginia. This is the day that the Lord hath made, and we ought to rejoice and be glad in it. We are so glad that you have come to worship with us on today. Our prayer is that something would be said or done that would bless your spirit in a mighty way. Our praise team is going to bless us now as we go into worship.
Good morning, Mount Pleasant, and welcome all of our visitors. How about you invite someone to worship with you today by sharing this post? We want the Lord to prepare us to be what He wants for us to be in life, what He's purposed and designed for us to be. Come on, put those hands together. Help us sing this out there. I know you know it. It says, Lord, prepare me to be a sanctuary, pure and holy, tried and true. And with thanksgiving, we'll be living sanctuaries for you. Lord, prepare me to be a sanctuary, pure and holy, tried and true. And with thanksgiving, I'll be a living sanctuary, oh, for you. Lord, prepare me.
Lord, prepare me.
Pure and holy before
you.
Tried
and true.
And with thanksgiving.
Yeah. I'll be a living
sanctuary before
sanctuary
you. Lord, for you.
For
say
you.
That again. Lord, prepare me.
Lord, prepare
to be a sanctuary.
Sanctuary.
I want to be pure and holy. What you want me to be.
What you want me to be.
Say, mold me.
Mold me.
What you want me to be.
What you want me to be.
Say, mold me.
Mold me.
What you want me to be.
What you want me to be.
Say, mold me.
Mold me.
What you want me to be.
What you want me to be.
And we'll say, yes.
Yes.
Yes to your will.
Yes to your will.
Say, say, mold me.
Mold
come on, tell
me.
The Lord what you want me to be.
What you want me to be.
Say, mold me.
Mold me.
What you want me to be.
What you want me to be.
What you want me to do.
What you want me to do.
Where you want me to go.
Where you want me to go.
How you want me to go.
How you want me to go.
What you want me to do.
What you want me to do.
What you want me to say.
What you want me to say.
What you want me to say. And we'll say yes.
Yes
to your will.
Yes to your
will. Yes
to your way.
Say yes.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Bless the name of Jesus. We honor his spirit in this place. We serve a great, awesome, and mighty God. He can do anything but fail in your life. So whatever you're needing God to do for you, just ask. If you need healing in your body, ask God for healing. Whatever you need for God to do, he's a great and awesome God. And he can do what no other power can do. So we let God know he's great and he's mighty.
Thank you, God.
Hallelujah.
Bless your name, God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, God. Yes, God.
Bless your name, Jesus.
Thank you, God.
Great and mighty is our God. Great and mighty is our God. Oh, great and mighty is our God. Great and mighty is our God. Everybody say,
great and mighty is our God.
Great and mighty.
Great and mighty is our God.
Nobody like our God. He's great.
Great are you, Lord.
You do miracles so great. Yeshua. You're in control, Yeshua. Even when I don't understand it, God, you're still in control, Yeshua. Great are you, Lord. Great is your mercy. Great is your mercy. Great is your faithfulness, God. Come on, one more time. Say, great are, great are you.
Once again, we are so grateful that you have joined the broadcast of the Mount Pleasant Baptist Church located in Herndon, Virginia. We are at 2516 Squirrel Hill Road, and it is our pleasure to have you joining with us on this morning for our morning broadcast. We're now going to have a few announcements for the Mount Pleasant Baptist Church.
Here are your Mount Pleasant Baptist Church ministry announcements.
As we continue to navigate this difficult time, we are expanding our educational opportunities and other online activities. We will be offering more Word Fuel classes on Sunday morning, Bible study classes throughout the week to go along with Pastor Donaldson's Bible study on Wednesday nights at 7 p.m., and even some fun family events like game night and exercise classes. Please check the RAM for an updated list of the classes. Remember, our motto is hashtag we build here. And during this time of isolation, we want to help build you up spiritually, mentally, emotionally, and physically.
Attention, all 2020 high school, college, continuing education, and military graduates. Listen up. We need your information.
And we need it now.
Because despite COVID-19, we're still going to be celebrating with you in this season.
So go ahead, get off the couch, get out of bed, and complete the 2020 graduation form, which will be posted on the Realm.
And don't forget to submit your 3 camera-ready JPEG photos and turn them in by the deadline date of May 22nd.
What date is that again?
May 22nd.
And by the way, since coronavirus has us all on lockdown, we are practicing
social distancing.
Go ahead and mark your calendars to save the date for June 28th at 1 p.m. for the 2020 graduation celebration watch party.
That's right. Since you can't come to us, we're bringing it to you.
So invite your family and your friends to watch with us. All forms, pictures, or questions can be submitted to the Young Adult Ministry at mpbc.org. Young adults at mtpleasantbaptist.org. Stay safe.
Saints, for the ongoing needs due to the coronavirus, community shelters are taking a huge hit to their pantry and clothing donations. We are asking you to please give generously to provide for our partner. We normally serve monthly on a regular basis, but we haven't been able to due to the pandemic. They are in desperate need, so let's demonstrate how Mount Pleasant looks out for the least amongst us during this trying time. The drop-off location at your earliest is Emory Rucker Community Shelter, 11975 Bowman Town Drive, Reston, Virginia, 20190. Their current needs consist of, for their food pantry, dry beans, lentils, rice, oatmeal, cooking oil, eggs, milk, cleaning products, and grocery gift cards. Clothing needed, adult t-shirts and sweatpants, size small to 4X, new men's and women's underwear, t-shirts, and sport bras. For the shelter, cleaning and disinfecting products and spray bottles, grocery gift cards, Target gift cards, full-size toiletry products. See the full wish lists online at www.cornerstonesva.org mountpleasantbaptistchurch.org/donations/wish-lists. Thank you, Mount Pleasant, for always showing the love of Christ.
For more information, please visit mtpleasantbaptist.org.
You're now in the know.
This concludes Mount Pleasant Baptist Church weekly announcements.
Thank you so much for hearing our announcements, asking that you would please check our church website and also the realm. Let me highlight one of our newer announcements. We are having a special event here at the Mount Pleasant Church on May 29th at 8 p.m. Virtually, we are going to have Laugh-alicious. We're going to have a comedy show by Zoom, and we invite you to come in and be a part of it. All of the details will be found on the realm. Please make sure that you come, and we need a laugh during the times that we're going through, and so we invite you to come and join with us on May the 29th. We're going to prepare our hearts now to go to the Lord in prayer. Gracious God, Lord, we thank you for another day. We thank you, oh God, because we realize, oh Lord, that we could not have been here without you. And so, Lord, we just say thank you this morning. We say thank you, oh God, because, Lord, you've been better to us than we've been to ourselves. We say thank you, God, because you watched over us last night, oh God. And Lord, with your finger of love, you touched us and woke us up this morning, oh God. And Lord, for that, we just say thank you. Lord, if we had 10,000 tongues, it wouldn't be enough, oh God, of how grateful we are for your many blessings. Now, Lord, we come asking that you please forgive us for all of our sins. Lord, whatever we've done wrong in your sight, wash us, oh God, with that blood that you shed on yonder's cross. Wash us, oh God, from the top of our head to the very sole of our feet. For Lord, the songwriter said, what can wash away my sin? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can make us whole again? Nothing but your blood. Now, Lord, somebody needs you this morning. Some need you for one thing and some need you for another. But Lord, we know you're God who can handle anything. There's nothing too hard for you, oh God. So, Lord, we put it in your hands right now. Lord, we declare victory over sickness. We declare victory over trouble. We declare victory over problems. We declare victory over it all, oh God. Because, Lord, we know you're able. Lord, we thank you because you've done it before, and we know you'll do it right now. So, Lord, we pray that you would dry somebody's eyes this morning, oh God, Wrap your arms around them and let them know everything is going to be all right. As long as they trust and believe in you, oh God. Lord, we thank you. Because, Lord, even though we're in a difficult time, oh God, you're still God. And you're still on the throne. Now, Lord, we need you to come and touch the preach word this morning. Oh, God, let us decrease so that your word may increase. Somebody out there needs to hear a word from you, oh, God. They need to come saying, what must I do to be saved? Lord, we thank you. We praise you. And we lift you up. In Jesus Christ's name, we do pray. And all God's people said, amen. Thank you, oh God, for the power of prayer. We believe that prayer works, that if you would just trust and believe in God, he is able to hear our cry. Listen, before we get ready to go into the preached word, we want to remind you this morning about the importance of giving back unto God some of what he has given unto us. For the Bible says God loves a cheerful giver. And even though we are in the midst of a pandemic and we know that many have lost their jobs and many are struggling, we know that God expects from us. He knows exactly what we have because he has given it to us. And our word teaches us that you reap what you sow. And if we would just sow good seed, God has promised that he would open up the windows of heaven and pour out a blessing for us. So as we prepare to give on today in our tithes and offerings, we just want to remind you there are three ways during this time that you can give back unto the Mount Pleasant Church. You can go online and you can give through the realm. You can do a one-time gift, or you can do a recurring gift, or you can give by phone. You can text the word MPBC Herndon to 73256. And you will receive a link on how you can give, or you can mail your check in to 2516 Squirrel Hill Road, Herndon, Virginia, 20171. Let me thank you once again for all that you have done in your giving, and I know that you are going to continue to please God in all that you do. Our choir is going to come back and bless us for a song as we prepare to share with you what God has laid on our heart.
My hands I acknowledge, I am yours to come and I surrender everything that I am with. glory I see, not my way, Lord, but your will I seek when I worship, when I worship. It's not all the things that you do, not the trials you brought me through, not because you're so faithful and true, but when I worship, it's just because I love you. Yes, I do. Yes, I do. Yes, I do. Yes, I do. When I worship, when I lift up my hands, I acknowledge I am yours to come and I surrender.
It's just because I love you. We are grateful for our music department for coming and blessing us this morning with the songs of Zion. If you have your Bibles with you this morning, turn with me to Matthew, the 11th chapter. Matthew, the 11th chapter, commencing at the 28th verse. Matthew, the 11th chapter, commencing at the 28th verse. And in this morning, for just a brief few moments, I want to talk about dealing with depression. Dealing with depression. Matthew, the 11th chapter and the 28th verse, therein reads these words. Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me. For I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. Grass withers and the flower fades, but the word of our God shall stand forever. Dealing with depression. Depression is real. No matter how you try to ignore it, depression is real. Depression is a mood disorder that causes a persistent feeling of sadness and loss of interest. It's also called major depressive disorder or clinical depression. It affects how you feel, think, and behave, and can lead to a variety of emotional and physical problems. It is estimated that 16.2 million adults in the United States of America have had at least one major depressive episode each year. An estimated 2.3 million adolescents ages 12 to 17 have dealt with one major depressive episode. Imagine what the numbers will be once this pandemic is over. People have lost their jobs. So much uncertainty. Children not able to graduate. Can't afford to ignore depression. And let me be honest with you. I have in the past and have no problem in the future counseling those who are depressed. But I tell people often that there is so much that I can do. I can share with you what the Word of God says. But there are some people who are depressed who need professional help. I'm not one of those pastors who thinks he knows everything, but I have no problem referring you to somebody who can help you outside of what the Word of God says. What I can do for people is to help them biblically. And I don't know what it was, but God spoke to my heart this week about helping people, because somebody out there, somebody under the sound of my voice this morning is dealing with depression. Some family member of yours is dealing with depression. Maybe your child is dealing with depression, and you don't know what to do. God sent me here this morning to just share with you a few principles on how biblically I think you can begin to handle this issue of depression. Our text, Jesus is speaking, and he knows that life is not easy. I know we like to walk around as Christians acting like we have it all together, like our lives are perfect and we don't have any problems, but that's just not reality. In fact, Jesus said, in this life, you will have some tribulations. I don't care who you are. I don't care what your title is. You are going to go through some moments in your life when you deal with some rough moments. But Jesus says, in that moment, Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened. He says, and I will give you rest. He's saying, I will give you the peace that you need. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me. For I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. Jesus is saying, if you're in that moment of depression, if you're in that moment where you're down, you don't know what to do, you don't know who to turn to, Jesus is saying, come to me. I have your answers. I have your solutions. If you would just come to me, if you would just make up in your mind that I'm going to trust in the Lord, lean not to my own understanding, in all my ways acknowledge him. And so this morning, hearing the words of Jesus saying, come unto me, I believe that there are five things that we can do to deal with depression. The first thing, brothers and sisters, if we're going to deal with depression, the first thing is we must stand firm in the Word of God. If you're going to deal with depression, you've got to stand firm in the Word of God. Have you ever experienced a moment in your life when you really needed to hear from the Lord, come unto me? How about a time when you were desperate for answers that you could literally scream? I believe it's in those times when the Lord really wants us to simply stand on the word. When Jesus says, come unto me, he's saying, come unto my word. I have given you the blueprint. Galatians 5:1 says, it is for freedom that Christ has set us free. Stand firm then, and do not let yourselves be burdened again by a yoke of slavery. Psalm 34:17-18 says, the righteous cry out, and the Lord hears them. He delivers them from all their troubles. The Lord is close to the brokenhearted and saves those who are crushed in spirit. If that's you this morning and you're crushed in spirit, Jesus is literally saying, come unto me, all ye who labor and are heavy burdened, and I will give you rest. Life has crushed you. Circumstances have crushed you. This pandemic has crushed you, and you're in a time of depression. Jesus is saying, come unto me. Standing on God's word is a choice. It is a wholehearted decision to trust him at every turn, even when doubt creeps in. You see, doubt is a faith killer, and our enemy Satan knows that. But that is when we must choose to stand on what God has said. It's in that moment. That's why Jesus says in Matthew 4, He says, it is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but on every word that comes from the mouth of God. What you will learn is that the word of God will be your lifeline. It will be your anchor. It will be your solid rock. It will sustain you. When you're in that moment of depression and you don't know where to turn and you begin to read your word, you begin to read words like, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. I will lift up my eyes to the hill which cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord. I can do all things through Christ Jesus who strengthens me. Weeping endureth for a night, but joy comes in the morning. The word of God will give you what you need in those dark moments. If you're going to deal with depression, the first thing you got to do is you got to stand firm in the Word of God. But number two, not only do you have to stand firm in the Word of God, but you must seek out the things of God. You must seek out the things of God. Matthew 6 and 33 says, "But seek ye first the kingdom of heaven and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you." Seek is a word you find quite a bit throughout the New Testament. In fact, the word appears over 100 times. The Greek word for seek refers to not just simply looking for something, but when talking about seeking God, Christ, and his kingdom, it tends to mean something stronger. In fact, it really, you could use a word like require, crave, and demand. You've got to require it. You've got to demand yourself that if I'm going to get out of what I'm going through, I've got to make myself seek the things of God. Colossians 3 and 1 says, "Since then you have been raised with Christ, set your hearts on things above where Christ is seated at the right hand of God." You see, that's a danger. So often we get in trouble because we seek the things of this world. Proverbs 14 and 12 says, "There is a way that appears to be right, but in the end it leads to death." We think we're doing the right thing, seeking the things of this world. But the problem is, the moment we lose it, the moment we don't have it anymore, that's why so many people are depressed right now, is because they put so much emphasis on the things of this world, on money and stuff. And when you can no longer have it, or it's snatched away from you, people begin to lose their minds. But when you seek out the things of God, you learn to look at the difficulties of this life in a different light. When the congregation in Rome was arguing about whether Christians should eat meat that might have been previously offered to idols, the Apostle Paul had to remind them to step back and look at the bigger picture. He wrote, "The kingdom of God is not eating or drinking, but righteousness and peace and joy in the Holy Spirit." Sometimes when you're in that moment, you just got to step back and look at the big picture and say, "Listen, I may not have everything I want, but thank God I have what I have. Thank God I'm not alive. Thank God I'm not on a ventilator. Thank God, listen, I may not have the perfect job, but right now there are 30 million Americans who wish they had any job." You got to look at the big picture. We as Christians, we can take comfort that the trials and difficult decisions of our life are only part of a much, much bigger picture, a picture that involves the kingdom of God that will stand forever. And let me just drop this in for free. What I've learned is that when you seek after the things of God, you don't have time to get sidetracked by other things. That's why Jesus had a one focused mindset, and he was here to do what God sent him to do. He was not going to let anybody divert him from getting to where God wanted him to be. That's why he was young. His mother and father came looking for him, said, "Don't you know we've been everywhere looking for you?" Jesus said, "I must be about my father's business." At the wedding of Cana of Galilee, when his mother said, "Whatever he says, do, Jesus said, "Listen, this doesn't have anything to, I have a reason to be here." Herod sent word one day, said, "Listen, Jesus, I want to talk to you." He said, "Go tell that old fox I must be on my way." Sometimes you got to tell life, "I don't have time for this. I'm about the kingdom. I don't have time to get sidetracked. I'm focused on the things of God. and building the kingdom of God. If you're going to deal with depression, you've got to stand firm in the word of God. You got to seek out the things of God. The third thing, if you're going to deal with depression, you've got to set aside your pride. You've got to set aside your pride. James, that fourth chapter, starting at that fifth verse, says, "Or do you think Scripture says without reason that he jealously longs for the Spirit he has caused to dwell in us? But he gives us more grace. That is why Scripture says, God opposes the proud but shows favor to the humble. Submit yourselves then to God, resist the devil, and he will flee from you. Come near to God, and he will come near to you. Wash your hands, you sinners, and purify your hearts, you double-minded. Grieve, mourn, and wail. Change your laughter to mourning and your joy to gloom. Humble yourselves before the Lord, and he will lift you up." You see, pride says to God, "I'm more important than you." Pride would have its own way rather than the Lord's. God alone is worthy to receive honor, glory, and praise, but pride tries to hijack it for ourselves. That's why we get so down in times where we're not in control, because we really believe that I have the power. We really believe that everything I have, I'm the one who got it. No, everything you have, God gave you. And if God is still on the throne, you don't have anything to worry about. No matter what it looks like, no matter how difficult it is, God is still in control. But pride won't allow you to see that. Pride says it's all about me. 1 Peter 5 and 5 says, God opposes the proud but gives grace to the humble. Which do you want from God? His opposition or his grace? If grace is what you want, it is vital that you lay aside your pride. I stopped by here to tell you, brothers and sisters, pride is the root of almost every sin. It has the audacity to disobey the loving, wise God who has purchased you. Pride wreaks havoc on your spiritual life. And this is really why pride causes depression. Because pride is that desire in you to receive all the praise. You know people like that. They've got to always get the praise. And if they're not getting the praise, if it's not about them, they lose their minds. It is the desire to be exalted rather than to glorify God. The proud person is confident in their own ability, and they do not rely on God's grace. And when things do not go the way they want, it causes them to be depressed. It is his pride, the wicked, that's what the psalmist said in Psalm 10, in his pride, the wicked does not see him. In all his thoughts, there is no room for God. See, that's what pride does. Pride pushes God out of our lives. You don't want to push God out, but you want to let God in. And so humble yourselves. Say, Lord, I need you. I can't do this by myself. I can't handle this by myself. I humble myself before you. Lord, you are in control. Have thine own way in my life. If you're going to deal with depression, you must stand on the word of God. You must seek the things of God. You must set aside your pride. The fourth thing, stop looking in your rearview mirror. If you're going to deal with depression, stop looking in your rearview mirror and focus on the future. I like how Paul put it to the church at Philippi in that third chapter 13th verse, he says, "Brothers and sisters, I do not consider myself yet to have taken hold of it, but one thing I do, forgetting what is behind and straining toward what is ahead, I press on toward the mark for to win the prize for which God has called me heavenward in Christ Jesus." He said, forgetting what is behind and pressing forward to what is ahead. Proverbs, the 4th chapter, 25th verse says, "Let your eyes look straight ahead. Fix your gaze directly before you." You know why too many people get depressed? Because they are so focused on what happened in the past. And now you've been quarantined. You sit at home. And all you do is you sit and you mope and you stew about things in your past. What I should have done, I could have done. If I would have done this, maybe I wouldn't be by myself right now. I wouldn't be single if I would have done this. And here I wouldn't have been quarantined by myself. I would have had somebody. And it will drive you crazy. But you got to make up in your mind, I'm going to press toward the mark. That I can't worry about what happened in my past. I've got to look to my future. I can't worry about mistakes. Even my mess ups, even my mistakes, the Bible says that God is just to forgive us of all of our sins. If God has forgiven you of all of your mistakes, why are you still allowing it to control your mind? Because you see, that's where Satan comes in, because Satan will start picking at you. Look at you. You by yourself. If you would have just done this, if you would have done that, if you would have made this decision, and it will lead you straight to depression. But you tell yourself, you know what? I can't fix what's behind me, but going forward, I can make better decisions. Going forward, I can follow God. I'm not going to let my past cause me to be muddled down in the miry clay. But God has given me new life. God has given me joy and peace. And my eyes are going to be on what's ahead of me. If you're going to deal with depression, stand on the word of God. Seek out the things of God. Set aside your pride. Stop looking in your rearview mirror. And the last thing, if you're going to deal with depression, shout like you already won. Somebody right now, just in hearing that, ought to start shouting. You ought to shout like you have already won. One of my favorite stories in the Bible is that story of Jehoshaphat. You remember Jehoshaphat heard that his enemies were coming to destroy him. He called a fast in the land. And after they had fasted and prayed, God sent word to the preacher, "Jehoshaphat, the battle is not yours, it's the Lord's." And I like in 2 Chronicles, the 20th chapter, in the 16th verse, it says, "Tomorrow go down against them. Behold, they will come up by the ascent of Ziz. You will find them at the end of the valley east of the wilderness of Jeruel. You will not need to fight in this battle. Stand firm, hold your position, and see the salvation of the Lord on your behalf, O Judah and Jerusalem. Do not be afraid and do not be dismayed. Tomorrow go out against them and the Lord will be with you." Then Jehoshaphat bowed his head with his face to the ground, and all Judah and the inhabitants of Jerusalem fell down before the Lord, worshiping the Lord. The battle had not even been fought yet. yet they decided it's time to worship. Even before we go down on tomorrow, we got to start shouting like right now, like it's already won. And somebody needs to hear that this morning. Psalm 98 and 4 says, shout for the joy to the Lord, all the earth, burst into jubilant song with music. Shouting is commended and commanded in the Word of God. Even before God shows up, you ought to just start giving God the praise and the honor. And what I've learned is you can shout your way right out of your problems. You can shout your way out of your storms. You've got to shout right now, even before God shows up in your life. Can I drop this on you? Shouting is therapy. See, instead of going online and spending all your money having boxes sent to your house, you ought to start shouting. Instead of going to the bottle, you ought to start shouting. See, people get depressed and do all kind of crazy stuff, ordering stuff you don't need, stuff you know you won't ever use, but you just say, you know what, this is the only thing that's going to allow me to keep my mind off what I'm going through, and it gives me some kind of, you know, momentary peace that, but eventually the boxes are going to stop coming because the money is going to run out. What do you do then when you drink all that you can drink? Oh, I've learned, brothers and sisters, it's at that moment you ought to just start praising God. You ought to just start worshiping God and just start shouting before God shows up. Start shouting before there's a vaccine. Start shouting before you get your job back. Start shouting before your loved one is healed. Start shouting before your child graduates. Before anything, you just start giving God the praise, the honor, and the glory. I read about a story about a man who was a famous singer. He'd been diagnosed with throat cancer. Doctor told him there's a good chance that you'll never sing again. As he was preparing to go into surgery, the doctor came by to see him one last time, and in a whispered voice, he said, "Are you sure I'll never sing again?" The doctor didn't even know what to say to him. He was so hurt. He could feel the hurt in the man's voice. The doctor just shook his head and says that there's a good chance that you won't sing anymore. But right there in that hospital room, right there before he was wheeled into surgery, before he was taken in where they were going to do a surgery where he wouldn't be able to sing anymore, they say that that man began to sing right there in his room. I don't know what song he sang, but I imagine that man saying, "If it had not been for the Lord on my side, where would I be?" I imagine maybe he sang, "Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine, oh, what a foretaste of glory divine." I imagine maybe he sang, "Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, let me stand." I imagine maybe he's saying, "Father, I stretch my hands to thee." Or maybe he just began to say, "Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord." The story was that that man had his surgery, and by the miracle of God, God gave him his voice back, and he was able to sing even in spite of what the world said. I don't know who I'm talking to this morning, but if you're dealing with depression, stand on the Word of God. Seek the things of God. Set aside your pride. Stop looking in the rearview mirror and shout like you've already won. And then if you do that, you'll be on the road to recovery from your depression. Oh, gracious God, we thank you, Lord, for your word. We thank you, oh God, for speaking to us even in these difficult moments. Lord, there's somebody this morning under the sound of my voice who is dealing with depression. Touch them right now. Your word says, come unto me, all ye who labor and are heavy burden. Somebody is dealing with a burden right now, oh God, and they need rest unto your souls. Touch them right now. Lord, maybe somebody knows you not in the pardon of their sins. Our prayer right now is that you would convict them, have them just put in the bar, I want to know Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior. And we know that one of our preachers will reach out to them, oh God. Lord, we thank you for your word. Your word is strength to us when we're down, when we're weak, when we're heavy laden. Knowing that, oh God, if we just trust and believe in you, that your word lets us know, oh God, that your yoke is easy and your burden is light. Lord, we thank you, we praise you, and we lift you up. In Jesus Christ's name we do pray. And all God's people said, amen. God bless you. It's our prayer that this word on today has been a blessing to you. We're asking that you would share it with your friends. Let them know that whatever you're going through, whatever you're dealing with, that God has everything that you need. And I do want to say this morning that if you are depressed and this sermon or the word of God is not enough, please don't be afraid to seek out help. Call somebody. Let somebody help you go through what you're going through. May God bless you and may God keep you. We thank you for worshiping with us at the Mount Pleasant Baptist Church. We want to let you know each Wednesday night we have Bible study at 7 p.m. This week, we just finished up a wonderful series on the fruit of the Spirit. Next two Wednesday nights, we'll be looking at spiritual gifts and how spiritual gifts are so important to our walk with Christ. But we pray that you would just continue to join us here online. Just want to let you know that we here at the Mount Pleasant Church believe that God is in control. We are not going to come back physically into the sanctuary until we know that it is safe for our members. We're not going to listen to what those in political office have to say, but we're going to follow the doctors and the scientists. And then we're going to trust and believe in God. I want you to know, Mount Pleasant, we have a team that is working together. We don't know yet when we will come back into the sanctuary, but we do have a team that is working, preparing so that when we do come back, everything will be in place. We encourage you because, listen, I said it on Wednesday night, church will not be the same for the foreseeable future. And we want you to be prepared. We want you to understand the differences, that the different things that we will have to do when we do come back. So we ask that you go to the CDC website, go to the Governor of Virginia's website. They have instructions specifically for churches. We want you to look at that. It will be tailored specifically for the Mount Pleasant Church, but we just want you to prepare your minds for church in the midst of a pandemic. God bless you and God keep you. See you on next week.